So this is a big one. For those of you guys that have looked into 2022, you may have seen this toolpath inside the multi-axis menu. This is a brand new set of toolpaths that combine. So if you look at the icon really close, you can see it's got four different types of toolpaths in it. What it's actually showing you is if you look right to the right there, you see parallel? Well, parallel cuts is a function in the unified toolpath. So is morph, and so is projected curves. So we have all that different functionality able to be used here. Cuts along a curve as well. So it's all of those different toolpaths kind of rolled into one unit. So we're going to take a look at this aerospace tube, and the next cut we're going to perform is going to be our cuts along a curve. So you can see here our cuts tilt underneath. We have an auto tilt function applied to this. So as the tool works its way down, it's going to automatically tilt to work underneath the edge to keep going. And we're going to apply that same thought process using the new unified toolpath. So inside of unified, we're going to use a guide curve, and we're going to go ahead and chain the green feature. So only the green chain. We're going to do this first half of this tube. And what we're going to choose is perpendicular to our curve. And we're going to go ahead and choose our orange surfaces. We're going to yield ourselves the exact same path we had before. We have the ability to use the same auto tilt parameters inside of the collision checking and the same entry and exit and transitions. And we're doing a one-way cut with a nice smooth transition that will work its way down through this tube, making slices truly perpendicular to the curve, and work its way all the way down and underneath that that undercut inside that body. Nice easy way for us to work through it. Another way to use this toolpath is going to be being parallel to a curve. So what we're gonna do is do the same thing. We're gonna open up our toolpath. We're gonna go add a curve row. And instead of perpendicular like we were a minute ago, we're going to solid edge select and grab the loop. That gets us all the way around the weldment of that boss. And this time we're gonna choose to be parallel to it. We can pick the surfaces we want to machine, and we're gonna reproduce that. That's a nice, easy way to go ahead and make changes in this toolpath to make a lot of different things happen effectively using one style of toolpath. Kind of ties everything together and makes it much simpler to use.